Hi, my name is Michael Schmoly, and I'm showing you a quick preview of the Maschine4Bitwig script that I've been writing. This just shows an overview. I finally got my equipment working for recording screencasts. I don't have the best webcam in the world, so it's a bit fuzzy, but this should do. Okay, Danny Lewis created a cool little intro video on how to install this. I'll post a link to that. It's just like installing any other script with Bitwig. Okay, basically this script uses a lot of functionality from the Push4Bitwig. Now, one of the things that is confusing people is the modes, and I had to figure out a way not to use these buttons, the machine pages. So I just created one page, and then these buttons and combinations of buttons will put the controller in a certain mode that you can edit things. So I'm using the Mark II right now. I have the studio in micro. The Mark I is actually working too. Someone tested that. Now, everything's basically the same except for some of the missing buttons, and I had to decide on a shift key. So on the Mark II, the shift key is enter. So whenever you press enter, when I say shift in the documentation, it's talking about the enter. And on the studio, it's enter. On the Mark I, it's the A, and the micro, I can't remember. I think it's enter. Okay, so the modes. This defaults in macro mode, and someone was having trouble with this. Dom from Bitwig suggested that we have it in macro mode by default, so I set it in macro mode. So how do you get from different modes on the controller without setting the default over here? And you can see this is set to macro. And you have device, common, envelope, direct, modulate, macro, and user. So if you were wanting to keep it in the default, you press navigate, and this shows you the modes. So it's clip, we have macro mode, which this mode, the first pad is all the modes, the mode banks. So when you set a default, it'll always default to this. So right now it's set to macro. And if you set it to device, you can see this switches to device. And then if we press device, you can see the arrow. And then we're into the device mode. And you can see the mappings here. And when you're in device mode, you can use the jog wheel, and it pages through each page. So right now, OSC 1, OSC 2, mix amp, filter, etc. Okay, so the navigate button navigates through modes. So you have the device mode, which is the actual bank mode. It's kind of confusing, but you'll get it. And so if I were to go to common, whenever I press navigate pad 1, it's on the common. So you can see that in the UI, the common is here. And there's no paging, because device mode is the only thing that has paging. Device pages, which are set up in the settings here. So we have all these. So that's what you're actually paging through. Okay. So navigate, we pick it, so pad 2 is track mode, so you have mute the track, solo the track, arm the track, monitor the track, and you can press F8 because to switch to the bottom row display. So the bottom row is the volume pan and the four sends. It's just giving you a label, switching the labels from what's on the bottom, and then it says the buttons on the top. Okay, so you can adjust the volume without being in that mode, but if you want to know what that is, it's volume and pan. And then you can set the pan. Okay, so that's track mode. And so we hit navigate again and go to scales. So right now, that's in C major. So if we want to pick any of the top row, we do the buttons. And if you want to pick the bottom, I have to fix these knobs. They'll eventually go back and forth, but enter. So now it's in F. And then to go up, you just press the button C. So it's back in C mode, C key. So these G, D, A, B, E, and then you can get to the flats down here. So then we have the in key mode, which puts the keyboard in key, so it's not removing the notes that are out of the C major scale. And then you can put it back in. And then you can notice that the pads are synced with the track colors, so if you change the track color, obviously everything changes. And then we can shift, we can go to minor. Okay, so that's scales mode, and then if you notice over here, you can also, this stuff is synced, so you can set some, a default, project default, and it will update to Dorian. And you can also set this stuff over here for defaults. And then you can do chromatic and in key over here, and you can see it adjusts over here when you switch it. Okay, that's track mode. And then we have frame mode, which is in construction, but these will toggle your different frames here. And if they're already there, so device, it'll collapse it. Mixer, device, automation, note edit. So that's a quick one. And another thing to note is that if you want a quick way to do that, I added a little shortcut. If you hold down the sampling button, so if we go back to device mode, and you just want to quickly look at your notes, you can long press it and go to note edit. And then, so we have navigate, so that's frame mode, and then we have clip mode, which can edit the active clip, which right now we don't. So we can press sample and page through the perspectives. So if we create a clip here, which the scene mode is in construction as well. There's a lot of things I'm still working on. So then we can quickly go to the node edit. And so this will now control how long the loop is, the loop start, the play end, play start, and if it's a loop or not, turns looping on and off, shuffle, and accent. So those are adjusting the loop properties here. Okay, so that's clip mode. And now we can do accent, which this is fixed accent. So if you're entering notes with it off, with it not lit up, it's entering velocity sensitive, low numbers, high numbers. But if it's fixed, it will always enter the 127 value, or you can adjust whatever your fixed accent is. So it'll always enter 100. So that's accent mode. And then we have scale layouts, which just change how, that's more complicated, but it changes how in chromatic mode, in key mode, how the scales are laid out. So you can see it adjusts thirds and fourths. Okay, and then we have your crossfaders for the track, for each track. So right now these are in the center, and you can move them A, B, or in the center. I gotta make that a little bit easier to use. And then we have the master mode, which can send. These are gonna be updated. I don't think I need four send modes right here. Then we have master mode, which then adjusts the master volume and master pan. I'm going to be allowing, right now you can't reset these values, but I'll have something with erase or something where you do that and press the button to erase it, to set it back to the default. Same with devices. And then, so that's master, and then we have volume, so then all the tracks you have, you can adjust the volumes right here. And you can see they're indicated in the UI. And then we have pan mode, same thing. All the tracks are indicated here. And then you can adjust the pans of all the stuff. And you can also turn this notification off in the controller settings. Okay, and last but not least, we have the global groove settings. So that's these settings up here. So if you're adjusting these, you can change this stuff with this mode, groove mode. Okay, so back to device mode. So you can see, then we can just quickly go back here and device and see our device. So we've got our mix. You can see the knobs have pretty good play. Okay, so that's the modes, and then we have the duplicates not implemented. We have select in pad mode, so select will select the track bank out of 8. So this will select track 1, polysynth, drum machine. And then if you have a bunch of tracks, you hit select, and this page is the track banks. So when it's lit up, it means you can go right. When it's lit up, and when it's dim, you can't go right. So then you can select your track really quick. And they're also up here for reference, selecting them. So if I want to go quickly to track 1, polysynth. Yeah. Oh, that's right, that got pushed to the end. Okay, and then you can also use the arrow, these are left and right to page through your tracks. So the F and H, and you can see when you can't go left, it dims. You go right. And then we have device navigation. So when you're here, these two buttons, the arrows, will page through the devices. So now I'm on delay, you can see. And then back to the polysynth. Haven't implemented sub-device navigation yet. That's complicated. And I think there's a couple bugs. We'll get to that. Okay, so that's navigation. And then we have the select. And then we have the device bank select. So if you don't want to set your default, you can press D and select, and then you can select the device bank, which it's not selected, we don't have a device there. Or you can select your common bank, envelopes, direct parameters, macros, which we don't, but we can make one really quick. And you see it pops up here. So now we have the frequency macro. Okay, And then we have, so that's device bank selection, device bank selection. And then you can also disable enable with this button. And then we have the solo, which will solo, obviously. So the blue is the current track. So if you want to solo the current track, and blue and yellow. So this is monitor up here. These are monitor. And this is the solo. So solo would be red. So all those are, you can see, solo. And then mute is the same. Unmutes. And the track bank. And then record arm. Okay. Running out of time on this one. But all the transport works. So play. Record arm. When you're in mix view, it will do the overdub, as you can see here, which is really good for doing quick clip recordings, which I'll get to later. But when you're in arrangement view, it will record that. But then you can also do shift, and it will do the overdub. So if you're in mix and you do shift, you can see, and then record. And then tempo, hold down, adjust the tempo, and then shift tempo does it in 100th increments. Okay, restart restarts the playhead, and shift restart turns the looping on and off. That's for arrangement, so you can see. So stop. And then one last one is the drum mode. So with the drum machine, we have these two. And when you're in pad mode, press it again, and then you can see the pads are colored, and you can add something, and then you can set the color. For some reason this deselects, and you got to get the active selection back on the drum machine. I think that's a bug, and it's not coloring this stuff right. So that's drum mode. I don't know why that's not coloring it. I gotta look at that. And then you can have mute, you can mute this stuff. This acts different in drum view. So you can do it like machine and solo. Okay, well, that was kind of fragmented, but I just wanted to show some people what's going on here. Oh yeah, and another thing, preset navigation. So you want to be in device mode. So we'd go D and then select device mode. And then if you want, do the polysynth. You hit, when you're in a device mode, any device bank mode, you can hit browse. And then you can pick your presets. Which I don't have the default Bitwig packages loaded right now on this computer, so none are showing up. Okay, well, that's... kind of the gist. I'll get a better video together. There's so much, this has to be in like 10 parts to get everything correctly, but I just wanted to show people kind of the usage of what's going on here so they can start playing around with it. Okay. Thanks a lot. I'll see you in the next recording.